Electric Works developer Kevin Biggs says environmental cleanup is already underway at a couple of buildings in the former GE campus. But before construction can begin, they need to meet key deadlines, and this extension will help them out.
With any big project comes a tedious process to get the idea off the ground. And for the Electric Works project, that is no different.
It is a monumental undertaking.
But to be able to begin construction on the mixed-use campus, first, the project has to secure needed funding. Developers are counting on millions of dollars in federal tax credits to help finance part of the project. However, because the federal government shut down for more than a month earlier this year, paperwork has backed up, and now the project is behind schedule.
That unforeseen challenge was going to make it extremely difficult, if not impossible, for us to meet some of the original deadlines that were spelled out in the economic development agreement.
To keep the project moving forward, the Fort Wayne Capital Improvement Board is giving Electric Works developers until the end of November to pin down needed federal dollars. It is extra time that developer Kevin Biggs says will also help them secure more tenants, which is something they need to do under their agreement with the city.
Which we have until now the end of November to be fully funded and closed on the capital stack for the project. And then construction will start, full construction.
The extension also gives developers until November to get signed leases for at least 250,000 square feet of space. Biggs says they have letters of intent for just under half of that space, but he's confident they'll find the rest in time.
We do have a pipeline of several hundred thousand feet of prospects that we are continuing to work with to bring them to the level of full LOI and then converting them into a true lease.
And Big says there is an announcement coming soon about a couple of tenants looking at space on the planned food hall on the campus. He says it's companies that the public will find very exciting. In studio, Ruben Solis, Wayne 15 News.